I'm Sven, I'm a team member of LabXchange, and if you're watching this video, you have probably just designed your guide RNAs in the CRISPR cluster. The purpose of the CRISPR cluster is to generate HIV-resistant macrophages. And as you recall, HIV needs two surface proteins on a macrophage to infect it. These proteins are called CD4 and CCR5. So what if we just deleted them to prevent HIV infection? The problem is that CD4 is an essential protein for the cell, so we cannot delete that. CCR5 is another matter. Hopefully, we can delete it without negative consequences for the cell, and this is why you have targeted CCR5 with your guide RNA, so that we can disrupt the gene CCR5 and delete the gene product, the CCR5 coreceptor, so that HIV cannot infect the immune cell anymore. So you have designed three guide RNAs that are supposed to facilitate the cleaving of the CCR5 gene so that we disrupt it and delete the CCR5 coreceptor from the macrophage surface. But how well do they actually work, these guide RNAs? To answer that, we have to design an assay, a DNA cleavage assay, and then use this assay in an experiment. So an assay is really any laboratory test that measures the activity of an enzyme, or it can measure the amount of a certain protein. So our DNA cleavage assay really monitors how much the guide RNA facilitates the cleaving of the CCR5 DNA. And it does so, as you remember, that the guide RNA forms a complex with Cas9. This is the protein that is many things, and among these things is the nuclease activity, which is important for our DNA cleavage here. So to monitor how well the guide RNA Cas9 complex cuts DNA, we need to create an assay with minimal components. So what are the minimal components for this assay? Obviously, we need to have DNA that gets cut, because that is the purpose of the DNA cleavage assay. So we need to add our CCR5 DNA into the tube. Okay. The next thing we have to think about is we're testing guide RNAs. How well do they facilitate the cleaving of the DNA? Obviously, we need guide RNA. Guide RNA cannot do the cutting on its own. It needs the Cas9 nuclease, the Cas9 protein around to do that. And after forming a complex with Cas9, the complex of Cas9 guide RNA will be directed to the target DNA. And if there's a perfect match between the guide RNA and the DNA sequence, then the nuclease activity of Cas9 is activated and you get a double-stranded cut in the DNA. So we also need the protein Cas9 in our minimal DNA cleavage assay. And because this is a biological reaction, we need to have it in a controlled and buffered environment. We need to have a constant pH, constant salt concentrations, that all the bioactive molecules in there are happy. So this needs to be in a buffer. And these are really the minimal components for our DNA cleavage assay. Now that we have a functional DNA cleavage assay, how can we actually visualize that DNA was cut by Cas9? Well, the answer is, of course, a DNA agarose gel. You recall probably that a DNA gel can separate DNA by size. And using a DNA gel, you always have to use a DNA ladder that serves as a size control. And this is how a DNA ladder looks like in a gel. The DNA ladder consists of larger and smaller DNA fragments. The larger DNA fragments migrate very slowly and stay on top of the gel. And the shorter ones, the smaller ones, migrate fast and appear at the bottom. So this size standard now sets a standard so that we can estimate the size of our DNA fragments from the experiment. And as I said, the assay we have designed is not an experiment yet. An experiment has a controlled environment. We need controls. One important control for this experiment now to determine which guide RNA facilitates the cutting of the DNA best. The most important control is to have the uncut DNA there. The uncut DNA is the CCR5 gene that in this case was PCR amplified, so we have it as a linearized segment of DNA. And this CCR5 DNA runs exactly here in the gel, just one band. Another important control is to make sure that Cas9 is specific in its activity. It needs a guide RNA to target it to the DNA, where the guide RNA matches with the DNA and then activates the nuclease activity. We don't want any non-specific Cas9 activity that cuts DNA here and there. So we want to make sure that Cas9 doesn't cut DNA with a random guide RNA. And that's exactly what we will have in the sample in lane 3. We have our CCR5 DNA and we have Cas9 that is in a complex with random guide RNA. We don't expect any cutting and only expect to see one band of uncut DNA, exactly like in the other control. Now that we have our experimental controls in place, we can finally test our three designed guide RNAs, A, B, and C. The samples will look the same for all of them. So in each sample, we will have the CCR5 DNA, we will have the Cas9 protein in a buffered environment, and we will have the guide RNA. But only the guide RNA differs now for these three samples because we will only use A or B or C in the three samples. So let's have a look how well guide RNA A facilitated DNA cleavage. In our gel, we see that it works actually pretty well because a significant portion of the CCR5 gene has disappeared in its uncut form. And we see instead the appearance of two fragments of DNA. And that makes sense because if you have a linearized DNA, the CCR5 gene, and we cut it once, you generate two fragments. And that's exactly what we see in the gel. So guide RNA A seems to work pretty well. How does guide RNA B look? Guide RNA B seems to be even more effective because we lose even more of the full-length DNA, the uncut DNA, and generate even more of the two fragments of CCR5. Guide RNA C, on the other hand, doesn't really seem to be working that well because most of the DNA remains uncut and only a tiny amount of DNA is fragmented. So if we now want to choose which are the two best guide RNAs to continue with our experiments, we would have to choose guide RNAs A and B. So now we are going to take guide RNAs A and B and use them in editing experiments in macrophage cell lines, in the hope that at least one of these cell lines will become HIV resistant.